Jerry Sandusky leaving the courtroom today with some testimony that could help his case and hurt it as well. The testimony from victim 7 and the co-worker of a janitor claiming to witness an assault were the big headlines of the day. Victim 7 talked about how Sandusky bear hugged him in the shower and picked him up off the ground, but he also may have helped the defense's case because he said he never told anyone about the abuse until the grand jury investigation. Also on the stand, the co-worker of a janitor who now has dementia relaying the encounters that his co-worker saw. Channel 11's Courtney Brennan brings us up to on the latest developments from the courtroom.
The most damning testimony against Jerry Sandusky came late this afternoon. It was very graphic and very detailed. Most of it we can't even say on television. Lawyers for the victims say that testimony painted a picture of Sandusky as the worst kind of pedophile, one who knew exactly what kinds of kids to go after. This is a sketch of victim 5. This young man cried softly on the witness stand as he told the jury about a sexual encounter with Jerry Sandusky.
He came forward, he put his hand on a Bible in a courtroom, he looked at 12 strangers on a jury, and he told them, "This happened to me."
Victim 5's attorney says Sandusky is a predator who knew what he could get away with. When his client refused Sandusky's sexual advance, Sandusky cut off all contact with him. Now, it took many years, but once this sex abuse story and the others came out, a Penn State janitor called police after reading the newspaper and told them about a sexual incident he heard about. The janitor says he went to clean the showers late one night in 2000 when Jerry Sandusky and a young boy walked out. He says Sandusky took the boy down the hallway and held the boy's hand. This janitor then told the jury his co-worker came up to him and was trembling. His co-worker said, "I just witnessed something in there I'll never forget for the rest of my life." Sandusky holding up that boy, licking on his privates. After this testimony, it was once again pointed out that these two sex crimes also happened in the Penn State locker room shower.
There were people at Penn State in positions of authority who knew about Mr. Sandusky and who failed to stop it. That's the Penn State story.
After that testimony from the janitor, the prosecution said they should have their case wrapped up by the end of the week. Reporting in Bellefonte this evening, I'm Courtney Brennan, Channel 11 News on Fox 53.
All right, Courtney, thank you. And count on us to bring you up to speed each day of the trial right here, every night on Channel 11 News on Fox 53.